few prescription drugs were as popular as the antipsychotic Seroquel. Psychiatrists trusted it, nursing homes used it, and addiction specialists prescribed it. Annual sales exceeded $3 billion. But in the winter of 2009, one of the top pharmaceutical sales representatives selling it, Allison Zayas, began to have her doubts. According to Zayas, one of her best clients, a doctor at a New York City outpatient clinic, told her that a patient had died while taking the drug and that the combination of Seroquel and methadone might have played a role. Soon after, Zayas recalled, two other doctors told her as many as 10 patients at New York methadone clinics had died taking Seroquel and methadone together. Zayas said she reported the deaths to her company, drugmaker AstraZeneca, but that it continued to aggressively market the blockbuster drug, even to methadone clinics. Their goal was to get in there and sell Seroquel, she told the Tribune in an interview. It was not, let's draw back. Let's take a look at the information. It was, get in there and sell. Everything is sell, sell, sell. Alarmed at the inaction, Zayas quit AstraZeneca and filed a whistleblower lawsuit against the firm, alleging it concealed the true cardiac risks of Seroquel when taken with certain other medications. The suit, filed in 2010, is a rare example of an employee of a major pharmaceutical company bringing a whistleblower claim over dangerous drug combinations. A filing last month in federal court in Brooklyn states the parties have reached a settlement in principle. A status report is expected by Monday. Bloomberg reported on the suit and the possible settlement last week. Drug interactions are a serious public health problem, hospitalizing tens of thousands each year. A Tribune investigation last year exposed how healthcare workers often fail to recognize drug interactions, prompting widespread safety changes at U.S. pharmacy chains. Drugmakers also have a crucial role in protecting and informing the public. Zayas' suit claims AstraZeneca failed to do either. Her suit claims the company withheld safety information from two U.S. Food and Drug Administration advisory panels and failed to alert patients, doctors, and pharmacists about Seroquel's heart risks. The FDA declined comment for this story. Zayas, a 46-year-old Manhattan resident, also claims AstraZeneca directed and incentivized its sales representatives to sell to doctors whom it knew prescribed Seroquel with methadone and other drugs that might trigger a dangerous reaction. Methadone is a powerful opioid that treats pain as well as addiction to narcotics. While others saw a crisis in the opioid epidemic, AstraZeneca cynically saw a financial opportunity, Zayas attorney James Pepper said. While others sent help, AstraZeneca sent sales representatives. Their job? To sell Seroquel to doctors who treated this very vulnerable patient population. A spokeswoman for United Kingdom-based AstraZeneca said the firm disputes the lawsuit's allegations but declined to comment further. In one court document, AstraZeneca said the 313-page whistleblower suit is long on words, paragraphs, and pages, but falls far short of stating a claim.